This is Odin. This is a directional pad, an arcade stick lever replacement. So what's this thing do? Well, it replaces one of these. This is a standard Sanwa JLF arcade stick with a bat's top on it. Something you'd obviously see in, well, something like this. It goes over here and you control your character's movement by moving this stick around. This Odin, made by OmniArcade, slots into here. It replaces your arcade lever with a pad with a WASD key, SAD W keys right over here. And it's a pretty popular thing right now. You see it in a lot of hitbox, mixbox, basically button-only arcade sticks have become very popular for a few different reasons. They offer very precise movement and controls in fighting games. They're also very useful for people who have RSI injuries that don't allow them to use an arcade stick or a thumb pad anymore. And they're also really fun and accurate and precise for kind of 2D action games, especially retro games on, you know, your NES, Super Nintendo, stuff like this. And that's one of the reasons I like this thing, is because it is very versatile. So this thing comes for about $64. You order it from Layer Shift, OmniArcade, and normally I ordered it and it was out of stock. It took about 2 months to get to me. It was a pretty easy ordering process. When you order it, they allow you to customize the color of it, the color of the keypads. They ask you what arcade stick you're going to be installing it into, and they then ship it out when it comes in stock. The whole setup cost about $64. It came with an extra kind of surround here. I've ordered a blue one. You can tell them what colors you'd like. It also comes with extra keys. So these are kind of low-profile keys that you would go onto a keyboard that uses kind of a low-profile design. And when you order the pad, it asks you, you can customize what kind of keys you get, and you get two different selections that you can then replace. They're very easy to replace in here. Under the surround is a PCB that the keys just kind of pop into. You also can get extra key caps. I got some black ones here. Again, these are a low profile design, so you can get these from other places as well, but you got to make sure you get the low profile ones. It also comes with a JLF cable. So that is the cable that comes off of your joystick and goes to your arcade stick. A couple of nuts to fasten the pad to your arcade stick, and an extra PCB. This isn't actually an extra PCB. There are two PCBs that are included with the package. One is a white one like this, and one is the black one that I have installed here. It just slides into the stem of the arcade pad. And depending on what kind of arcade stick you're installing it into, you'll swap between the black and the white one. So for some arcade sticks, you'll need the white one. For some arcade sticks, you'll need the black one. And in the box, there are directions that tell you the compatible fight sticks and which PCB you need to use for each fight stick. That is also available online, so you'll know that your fight stick is compatible before you actually order the Odin. To install this thing is very, very simple. Obviously, I've already taken out the standard joystick, and you do that just by taking out these four screws here. To put the Odin in place, you just slide this stem in through the top. There's kind of a sticky-ish rubber coating on the bottom to hold it in place. Just put that in. You can kind of customize the orientation to whatever feels comfortable for you. And then on the bottom here, these two plastic nuts just go right around the joystick. And then the second one is kind of a lock nut to keep the first one in place. Plug the connector in, and you're done, essentially. On this 8-bit do arcade stick, you actually have to put this cable in place. I have another video about how to completely upgrade this stick. I'll link in this video as well, but you're done. It's that easy to install, and it's that easy to go back and forth. If you want to put your lever back into the arcade stick, all you have to do is take it out and use these four screws to fasten the arcade lever back in. Why would you want to do something like this? Well, button-only arcade sticks have kind of become pretty popular, whether it's Hitbox, Mixbox, or several other configurations and brands. Basically, what this allows you to do is use the keys to have very precise inputs when you are controlling your character. In a fighting game like Street Fighter, it really allows you to hit just the buttons and directions that you want to hit. So, for instance, with a arcade stick, or with a lever here, you might find that you think you're hitting down, but you're actually hitting down and back, or down and forward, or you think you're going to jump straight up, but you actually hit up and forward a little bit, and that can be imprecise. With charging characters, you have to charge back, then hit forward. And that can actually be improved with the buttons. And there's tons of videos about how to use a button-only layout, either a hitbox or a mixbox, to improve your fighting game. So I'm not going to go into that. I'm not an expert fighting game player. But it can be very advantageous to use a button-only layout for fighting games. But it also works quite well for 2D games. 2D games, either on a modern console like a Switch, or on a classic console like an NES or a Super Nintendo or a Genesis. I've used it on the Mister to play arcade games. I've used it, you know, for everything. And it's really been quite versatile. It really allows for very precise movements, kind of once you get used to it. Because even if you are a keyboard and mouse player, if you're familiar with playing games on PC and using the WASD layout or the SADW layout on your left hand, controlling games, 2D games, can be a bit of an adjustment. But once you get used to it, once you start building up the muscle memory, what you find is it actually becomes very precise. And you only hit the buttons and directions that you really want to hit, because there's no vagueness to it like there is with an arcade stick or a thumbpad. You really have to positively hit the key that you mean to hit. So if you want to hit, you know, down, then you only hit down. If you want to hit down and back, then you only hit down and back. There's kind of no mistaking it, assuming that you have the muscle memory that allows you to do it when you want to do it. Also, if you have RSI injuries, you might not be able to use an arcade lever anymore, or even a thumb pad anymore. So this can actually allow you to play games if you have an injury that just has been keeping you off of, you know, levers or thumb pads, which can be really good. So it's a really fun new way to try out a completely button-only arcade stick, right? You kind of lose the stick name, and it can be a little bit confusing talking about it because you no longer have a stick. The lever is gone. Now your arcade stick is all buttons. And that can add a new way of playing games, but this is also kind of a low-cost way to get into that. Something like a Hitbox or a Mixbox can cost $150, $200. So that makes the Odin at $64 seem like a pretty good bargain, at least to try it out. If you're interested in getting into a button-only design, I gotta say, I highly recommend this thing. Under here, the PCB is all custom for this. This is all 3D printed. The surround here is 3D printed. The keys are name brand keys. You can customize those even after you order the ones that you want. The ones that they sell or they give you with your $64, you get to select two types. They're all name brand. They seem high quality. Everything about this thing seems very high quality. It seems built to last. I've had no complaints in the 2 months I've been using it. I've been using it quite a bit over the last 2 months. And it's nice that you can customize it right out of the box. So if you want to put black keys on there, if you want to put the blue surround on there, you can get all sorts of different colors of both keycaps and surrounds to really customize the look of it to whatever your arcade stick is and whatever style you're going for. It's quite a fun little device, and it's a more affordable way of trying out a button-only arcade stick design, because you know what? It might not be for you, and if you bought this, at least you didn't spend $200 on a brand new arcade stick that you're never going to use again. The Odin is much less expensive. It's much less of an investment than something like a completely custom-built arcade stick, because you're just converting it over. And You're also not stuck with just one because you can just swap in the lever if you're playing an arcade game that you feel the lever is more appropriate or the lever is your preferred button input. It's a pretty cool device. $64. It's available online. I'll put a link to their website. The ordering process is a little odd. It doesn't seem to ever be in stock. So what you do is basically get into a queue. You basically wait to pre-order it. And then once it becomes in stock, they send you an email. They say to me, they basically said, hey, you still want this thing? I said, yes. So they charge you the card that you put in there and they ship it out to you. It comes pretty quick once they actually charge you, but they don't charge you until they ship it, which is kind of nice. That's not something that every company is doing right now. But you know, nothing's ever in stock anymore. That's just the world we live in. So this is the Odin by OmniArcade. And I gotta say, I highly recommend it. If you want to try out a button only arcade stick, this is a pretty affordable and fun way of doing it. Plus, you get to open up your arcade stick and customize it yourself, which is pretty fun. If you want more information about this 8-Bit Do arcade stick and customizing this, I'll put a link to that video in the description as well, so you can check that out. I've liked this arcade stick quite a bit. It's very compatible with a lot of different devices, PC, you know, all sorts of like RetroPie boxes, the Switch, all sorts of different stuff. And it's been pretty fun. So thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.